Mini chapter 82, Jaymi incarnates the Platinum Raven. Back at the house on Zeus Drive, alone at the end of the terrace, Jaymi clutches the edge of his seat in a terror of excitement as he watches the Platinum Raven slither and slide out into meat space through the monitor in front of him. She steps down onto the flat stonework and stands there with majestic poise, looking about her. All the transcendence he could create from within him, and his very own response to Bangdead's arts score. He gets to his feet and gazes at her as if at a beautiful ghost. Flaming orange in the bank of dark foliage beside them, the bird of paradise flowers ooze thick sweet sap, as they do all night, drips of nectar spilling down their bulbous orange petal-bases, side-lit by the terrace lamps. Of all his five beasts, she is not here for conversation, he's aware, at least not for the kind that tends to be recognized as such. Rather, she looks and breathes a grander, cleaner colloquy above the level of spoken words or personal identities. So it's to this level that Jaymi fires up his hearing and his sight, holding those senses there as lightly as he can, while she binds him into the spell of a story whose beginning is intimate, spoken straight at him through her eyes without words. A woman was once distraught on waking to find that the diamond ring she had placed in a saucer of oatmeal by her bedside as usual, so as to keep the stone clear following the old superstition, had vanished. By and by, she died. 10 years later, while her children were making improvements to the house, they found the ring under the floor around the neck of a mouse's skeleton. Her gaze disengages from Jamie's and swings to the right, coming to rest over his shoulder at the Pacific, as if at a sunset in the past. Strange to say, he cannot remember whether a sliver of the ocean is in fact visible from here. He should surely know. But he's not inclined to turn around and verify this, when instead he can watch, reflected tiny in her eyes, the waves of a sea bulging and shrinking like muscles in the curve of the hydrosphere. Amid the waves, a hole in the ocean opens, an inverse waterspout, and thus she funnels his attention back to when the Tethys Sea was caught between colliding Eurasian and Indian plates and squeezed up into the Himalayan mountains. She gives a gentle shrug. Seas change, after all. For a moment, she closes her eyes like a moon blink. Her pink noise, more than a mains hum, he reminds himself, resolves to a music of atom and planet, and onward she draws him and flings him out further through a sound of darkness singing. You're what Saturn's rings enclose, and I'm the rings of Earth, he thinks he hears within her pink noise, in a voice like the twanging of a string 10 meters thick, its other end tethered somewhere in between the stars, and its nearer end tethered on this Zeus Drive terrace where she stands statuesque. Concluding her emergence, she telescopes Jaymi and herself to a height several stars away, flying through a special sky that's all her own, where giant billboards drift in space, her face depicted on them where they billow through the vacuum as ships pass in silence. Her eye on one such billboard gives a slow wink. And there, within this wink, her grandest view tunnels out, fans wide, spans and hovers for an instant, an infinite series of bang, crunch, bang, crunch, destined to be done by the universe forever. And the terror, the enslaving futility and cosmic enormity of this. Underneath the wink on the giant billboard, her lips part with a burst of ultraviolet shadow, mouthing, catch you later. Her eyes close, both up there and down here on this terrace. Jaymi drops his gaze from her face and bows his head. While west of LA, above the highway up the coast, the cables on the pylons crackle in the night sky.